Auschwitz, Treblinka, Dachau, the days of desperation for the Jews in Warsaw. Hello, my name is Karis McGuire. I'm from Grace Christian School in West Columbia. Today I will be performing a cutting from the novel Mila 18 by Leon Harris. Rachel thumbed through a stack of sheet music and selected several. Then she put on her Star of David armband as her mother looked on. Dear, are you sure it is safe to give a recital today? I feel so uneasy about it. Mom, there haven't been any deportations for 4 days. They're arranging programs all over the ghetto to get people's minds off the past 3 weeks. Besides, I'll be playing at your orphanage in Miska. Nothing could possibly happen to me there. Well, be careful just the same, Rachel. I will be there. Goodbye. Rachel opened the door and stopped. Strange, being able to walk in the streets again. The assembly hall at the Niska Street Orphanage held most of the 400 children. It was one of 28 institutions which, somehow, managed to both feed and secretly educate over 20,000 parentless youngsters. Rachel was the favorite of all the children. They crammed together, filling all the benches, sitting in the aisles and on the floor before her piano. The teachers, nurses, and other doctors stood along the back wall. Rachel held up her hands for attention. Children, what would you like to hear next? Rachel, sing to us about Palestine. All right. The roses bloom in Galilee, and the lambs rejoice. Round the day and through the night, we lift our thankfulness. We love you, our Galilee. Your land makes our hearts sing. We'll guard you true. Susan Geller, the head of the orphanage, was not a beautiful woman, nor did she have a particularly vibrant personality. It was her courage and determination that kept the orphanage going. Now, she entered the hall, went to the front, and sat down beside Rachel on the piano bench. At the end of the song, I will make an announcement. You keep playing. We want no panic. Do you understand? Susan! Keep playing, Rachel. Keep playing. Children, Aunt Susan has a most wonderful surprise for you. Today, we are going on a picnic. Her announcement was greeted with oohs and ahs of disbelief. We are all going on a train ride out of the ghetto, where we will see all those lovely things we have talked about. Trees and hills and farms. Now, don't be afraid of the soldiers. Today, they're just here to help us out. Rachel, won't you play us something wonderful while we all march outside? Susan stepped into the corridor just as the Nazi lieutenant entered the building. She quickly blocked the door to the assembly hall. We are quite ready. If you will kindly inform your men not to alarm the children, we will keep them calm. We just want the children, not you. We choose to go. Surely you cannot object to having us resettled with our wards. The German sneered. He didn't like her homely face. Have it your way. Get them out into the streets. Jews. They have some kind of strange love for dying like mortars. He remembered the fathers holding their hands over the son's eyes at the edge of the pits of Babi Yar at Kiev. What do you have in the bag? Chocolates. occasion, like today. Susan looked at the soldier, then down at the chocolates. She knew it would be one of two things for Jim. A torturous, agonizing end at one of Hitler's death camps. Or the chocolates. So slowly, Susan reached out and took the bag. The courtyard bulged with 10,000 ragged, emaciated children, with a sprinkling of nurses and doctors who kept up a play of gaiety. Some of the older children, who knew where they were going, kept it to themselves. Well, children, now begins our wonderful picnic into the country. Aunt Susan, when will we come back? Oh, probably later tonight. The train rattled as it rolled across the countryside. Children, I have another surprise for you. We have chocolates. Chocolates! Susan passed the bag of poisoned chocolates around to the children. There. Now doesn't that taste wonderful? Let's all sing for a while.
Hi, Susan. I'm getting sleepy.
I'm sleepy too, Aunt Susan.
Well, why don't you all lay your heads down and rest? It must be all this fresh air and excitement. One by one, they closed their eyes. Susan Geller sat down on a bench and snuggled between a pair of her babies. She held them close to her as she slowly swallowed the last piece of chocolate. At that moment, she remembered a lullaby her mother used to sing to her. Sleep, my little bird. Close your eyes.